think that the current SRC dues is sufficient, or you would go to General Assembly and get an increment in dues, and why?
Say again, I am not going to increase the dues of the GIS student.
Let's be realistic here.
The SRC leadership must be innovative enough to look for money from external sources in supporting the SRC.
Most of the time when we are talking about the student dues, we are only thinking about the regular students. We also have the weekend students at hand. And when you go and speak to the weekend students, they tell you that they are doing absolutely nothing for them. So for me, my position is that it's either we maintain it at 50 CDs or a little increment.
Just as I was able to look for money to support a course of very deprived students in Salaga, I will look for that money to support the SRC. We will not pay more, and that's my position.
If you still want to have the boring SRC weeks that you have, then you would either reduce the amount or maintain it at 50 CDs.
50 CDs SRC fees that we are paying right now, I believe it's enough.
I will not deceive you here by saying that I'm going to reduce it, come into power and increase it.
I am not saying this thing because it is imaginary. I am saying it because I have sent a package before that brought a lot of money, and doing it at the SRC will not be different at all. The records are there.
You are sitting under the branded SRC canopy. There was never a receipt or an invoice presented to you.
And I'm quite surprised that Jonah, for example, said that they have not presented an invoice to General Assembly. We are all members of General Assembly, and we know SRC Executive Committee is not supposed to present an invoice to General Assembly. We know we're supposed to appoint the auditor. Then the auditor goes and audits all of these things and presents a report to General Assembly. And this is something that he's very much aware of.
As it stands now, you can ask him.
I believe that we need to get external audited.
When was the last time financial secretary came to GA to provide anything of that sort? It has never happened.
To say we are bringing somebody else, then you are to a very large extent going to breach the constitution. So the constitution, the constitutional review process that is ongoing, must take note of changing some of this. Proud to students coming to school the next semester, ourselves will form a committee and look at getting places of convenience from hostel owners or from room owners. I have started making accommodation arrangements for students at University of Ghana by new hostel. Now, as I speak to you, we have 200 new rooms that are available with 24 hours internet, a balcony, and library.
We are deceived when it comes to some of these things. They come to our classes and they tell us that we are going to provide hostels for you here and here and here. And at the end of the day, they go and provide a place that does not even have light.
And he says, subsequent to SRC admission, they come to class, talk about it, and nothing happens. They even provide you with a place that there's no light.
Can only take about 20 to 30 students. Those things must stop.
Needs to check his facts. When he says subsequent administrations have always done those things, and it has never happened, it is not true.
What you want is probably a one-bedroom house and a washroom and self-contained and whatever.